Hello and welcome to CircleCI Foundations. I'm Zan, a developer advocate at CircleCI, and today we'll be looking at the parameterized configurations in your pipelines. We will cover what they are, why they're interesting, and how to get started. Let's begin. Parameters let you reuse parts of your config files, such as jobs, commands, and orbs, without you having to replicate their whole code. For example, if you write the same job that you wish to execute on different machines, you could either copy-paste the entire job code just to change the executor, or you could pass that executor as a parameter and do so without also duplicating the rest of the definition. This means that your config files will be shorter and much easier to maintain. What can you parameterize? Parameters can be either primitive types, such as integers, strings, booleans, or enums. For example, you might want to use integers to denote the pipeline number or when splitting tests. On the other hand, you could use a string parameter to specify which cloud environment you are working with in a particular job, such as staging, dev, or prod. You can also pass in advanced types of parameters, such as executors, steps, or environment variable names. Steps, for example, are especially useful if you want to tweak behavior after a test job has completed. Even if you haven't created any parameters yourself, you have probably used them, if you used any of the CircleCI orbs. For example, the Node.js orb lets you configure the built-in test job by specifying a package manager, the command that you wish to run, node version you'd like to use, and more. Looking at orb docs, you will find all parameters for commands and jobs referenced alongside their descriptions, types, and default values. In this example, we're specifying the node versions we want to use in three parallel test jobs from the Node.js orb. That way, our packages are installed and tested on node versions 12, 14, and 15 with way less effort than writing everything yourself. Now, let's take a look at how to create your own parameters and use them in your config files. First, make sure you're using the config file version 2.1. Next, define parameters at the top of your stanza that you wish to parameterize. In our case, we're defining parameters in our job named build. Each parameter has a name and a type. Ours has a name p and type integer. You can also optionally give your parameter a default value. If you add a default value, then you don't have to always pass in this parameter when using this job. In our case, default value is set, so it will just assume p value is 1 if we omit it when referencing this job in a workflow. You can also give your parameter an expanded description. To reference a parameter, use the following syntax. Parameters.parameterName within. Here, we are passing a p parameter to define the parallelism of the build job. This syntax also lets you do string interpolation to combine parameters with more static strings. To pass a parameter, declare it when invoking the job or command that contains it, using the same name and type. Here, we're passing it to our build job to set parallelism to 2. That was the quick introduction to parameterized configuration options in CircleCI. I hope you found this video useful. If you'd like to learn more about parameters, check the link in the description. If you have any questions or suggestions for us, join our community at discuss.circleci.com, where many helpful folks are hanging out and answering all your questions. Until next time, happy hacking. Bye.